Mr. True, one more time today. Oh, like the shirt, by the way? Every Friday's a funny shirt, whether you like them or not. Okay, so we're going to do a little factoring review. Definitely a sore spot with some of even my pre-calculus kids. So I've got a few examples up here about factoring, and let's take a look at them. Okay, the very first thing you should ever try when you have to factor is there something in common that all the terms can give up? Can you just simply divide out a common factor? And with this binomial here, they both have a 3. 15 and 3 are both divisible by 3. And both of these terms also have an x to give up. How many x's can you take out? This has 2 to give up, and this only has 1 to give up. When you're factoring out variables, you can take out the lowest number of those variables. So these both have a 3, and both of these terms have an x. So we're going to take 3x squared and divide it by 3x, and 15x and divide that by 3x, and factor out, pull out, or undistribute the 3x, the common factor. So we got 3x. 3x squared divided by 3x is just x, and 15 divided by 3 is 5, and x divided by x is 1. So 3x squared plus 15x equals 3x times x plus 5 when it's factored. Okay, this one here, my pre-calc students haven't even seen much of yet, and these two terms also have a common factor. Those two terms both have an x. But you might be going, yeah, but those have negative exponents. That's weird. I don't get that. Well, I'm going to do this just like I did a simpler example over here. Both of these terms have an x in them. So I'm going to pull an x out. Now, how many can I take out? Well, I just told you that when you're factoring out a common factor, when you're factoring out a common x in this example, you take out the lowest exponent. This has 2 to give up, but this only has 1, the lowest exponent. Well, what's lower, negative 5 or negative 3? On the number line, negative 5 is farther to the left. Negative 5 is a smaller exponent. So that is how many we are going to take out. So we get x to the negative 5th is going to come out of x to the negative 5th over x to the negative 5th, I'm dividing out, plus 2 times x to the negative 3rd divided by x to the negative 5th. And if your class is not doing ones like with negative exponents, you can ignore this example or learn from it, but you might be beyond your difficulty of your class. X to the negative 5th, anything divided by itself is equal to 1. So x to the negative 5th divided by x to the negative 5th is simply 1. Plus 2 divided by 1 is 2. And what do you do when you divide like bases? If you've been studying exponents recently, you know that when you divide like bases, you subtract the exponents. So this is going to be x to the negative 3 minus negative 5. Well, what's negative 3 minus negative 5? When you minus a negative, that's the same as addition. So negative 3 plus 5 is equal to 2. Beautiful. That is factored. And there you go. You might not have ever seen factoring out a common factor when the exponents are negative, but they work just like your simpler ones do that maybe you're more comfortable with. Now, when you have a trinomial and no common factors come out, then the only chance you have, or the only way you have of factoring it, is set up your two parentheses and start, you know, putting factors of the first term in the first two blanks and factors of the last term in the last two blanks. Well, some students always struggle a little bit with factoring, so I don't want to say it's easy, but when your leading coefficient is 1, as far as factoring is concerned, those are the easier ones. When you just simply want to ask yourself, what factors of this last constant, either add or subtract, in this case subtract, because it says minus, to the middle term. Factors of 24 that minus to the value and give you a negative 2 when you subtract them. We got 1 and 24, 2 and 12, 3 and 8, and you have 4 and 6. So if I write x plus 4 and x minus 6, these factors of 24 will subtract 4 minus 6, does give me negative 2. And if you want to check that, this is the correct answer, but if you want to check it, which is always a really good idea, then you just start foiling this back out. X times x is x squared. X times negative 6 is negative 6x. 4 times x is positive 4x. And positive 4 times negative 6 is negative 24. And there you go. Look, negative 6 plus 4x is your negative 2x. So this answer does check out. Very nice. All right. What if you have a leading coefficient of 1 still, but your last sign is positive? Well, instead of saying factors that subtract to the middle term, you'll say factors that add to the middle term. And what factors of 15 add to 8? There's not many to choose from. 1 and 15 is 16, and 3 and 5 is 8. So this will be x plus 5 and x plus 3. If your last sign is positive, your two signs and your factors are always going to be the same. What if I change that 8 to a negative 8? Well, I just said when your last sign is positive, these have to be the same. They don't have to both be positive, they both have to be the same. So, what factors of 15 add to negative 8? Well, negative 5 and negative 3. So, if you're watching this video, I did just change the question on you. Please pay attention to that. Okay, so then that's factored. Now we get to the issue, maybe. Hopefully not when this is done. Now we're factoring a trinomial that has a leading coefficient that is not equal to 1. Back in my days, when I first started teaching and learning algebra, it was all trial and error, and it sucked. Okay, I hated it. Well, now they're like, hey guys, there's a way to factor these trinomials where it's not trial and error. Just a little bit of scratch work on the side. If you have a trinomial and nothing comes out, you always look to see if there's something that can divide out of all three of them first. If you have a leading coefficient that is not 1, here's what you want to do. Take the first and last term and multiply them together. This is scratch work on the side. First and last term, multiply them together. 3 times negative 20 is negative 60. Talk about trial and error. There's all kinds of combinations you can come up with. So what we want to do now is what factors of negative 60, what factors add to the middle term of negative 11? Well, you got 1 and 60, 2 and 15, 3 and 20, 4 and 15. So, and it has to be negative. So the 4 or the 15, one of those has to be negative. And that's going to be, if I want to get negative 11, it's going to be negative 15 and positive 4. Now all I'm going to do is rewrite this to look different. I'm going to rewrite the middle term with these factors, which I didn't write down, of positive 4 and negative 15. So this is going to be 3x squared minus 15x plus 4x minus 20. Again, these two middle terms still add up to negative 11, right? So all I've done is made the equation or the expression look different. And the negative 15 and the positive 4 came from factors of 60 that added to the middle term. Now I'm done with my scratch work. Now I've got 4 terms instead of 3. What do you do when you have 4 terms? You do something called factor by grouping. And when you factor by grouping, you work with the first two terms and the last two terms separately, temporarily. What comes out of the first two terms? They both have a 3. 15 is divisible by 3. And they both have an x. Now, what's 3x squared divided by 3x? Well, 3 divided by 3 is 1, and x squared divided by x is x. 15 divided by 3 is 5, negative 5. And the x's will cancel out. Now, I'm going to take something out of the last two terms to make this factor of x minus 5 show up again? What does 4 and 20 both have in common that I can divide out and give me x minus 5 when I'm done inside the parentheses? Positive 4. So I'm going to divide out a positive 4, and 4 divided by 4 is equal to 1. 20 divided by 4, negative 20 divided by 4 is negative 5. And now look, I've got matching factors again. So we got x minus 5 times 3x minus 4, and you can check it, but that's the right answer, and that's factoring. Woo!